Leave a Message for Willie, a Sharon McCone mystery by Marcia Muller, narrated by Laura Hicks. Chapter 1.
You want any of those paintbrushes? They're all half price.
The vendor, in cut-off jeans and a baseball cap, loomed over me as I squatted, considering his wares. I rocked back on my heels and looked up at him.
Business is slow, huh?
Nah, I'm generous is all. Half price, and you buy 10 brushes. I'll knock off another dollar.
What on earth would I do with 10 of them?
He grinned, his suntanned face creasing into deep lines.
Open your own stall. That's how I got started in the flea market business.
I'll take 2. I stood up and fumbled in my bag for change. The man shook his head.
Some people wouldn't know a bargain if it bit them on the ass.
I waggled the brushes at him and started down the crowded aisle, looking for my friend Don. The Salt Flats Flea Market was spread over several acres, sandwiched between the Bayshore Freeway and the Frontage Road, near the little town of Brisbane. During the week, it was nothing but a barren, rock-strewn plain. But on Saturdays and Sundays, the vendors streamed in. They erected booths with colorful canopies or sold their goods from blankets on the ground. Balloons flew, banners waved, and music from dozens of radios, most tuned to country and western stations, filled the air. I weaved down the aisle, avoiding baby strollers and a kid on a bicycle, and spotted Don at a stand featuring stereo equipment. He was closing in on a bunch of speakers with an ardent disc jockey gleam in his eye, and I quickened my pace, knowing I'd better get him out of there fast. By the time I reached him, he was crawling on his hands and knees, examining the connections at the back of one speaker. I nudged his foot with mine, and he looked up, his expression blank for a moment.
It's me, Sharon, remember? Oh, yeah. We've met someplace. Give me a minute and I'll figure out where.
Then he looked back at the speaker, a shade wistfully.
These are a terrific deal.
Of course they are. They're probably hot. Don straightened up to his full 6'2", brushing dirt off his hands. He raised one dark eyebrow and waited.
A lot of the stuff they sell here is, I went on. Some of the vendors are legitimate business people and craftsmen, but quite a bit of fencing goes on, too.
Don continued to wait, stroking his shaggy black mustache, his hazel eyes interested. At the beginning of our relationship, I'd taken this quiet interest to be boredom, mainly because he'd struck me as such a motor mouth when we'd first met. But as we'd become closer and more comfortable with one another, I'd realized he only chattered when he was nervous or felt he needed to be on stage. Don Del Baccio, star disc jockey of a mid-coastal radio station, conserved his words in his private life as much as he squandered them on the air.
This particular flea market, I said, has a reputation for tolerating illegal activity. I myself just bought what are probably hot paintbrushes to use on the trim in the living room.
Don put an arm around me and began steering me through the crowd.
You bought hot merchandise when you're here on a mission of law and order?
I wouldn't label meeting with a prospective client as a mission of law and order, but I did promise my boss I'd look the guy up. So I guess I'd better quit wandering around and try to locate him. Supposedly, he has a stall here.
Why not ask one of the other vendors? Maybe the guy at the snow cone stand can tell you. I'll treat you to a cone.
Okay. A rainbow one, please. The snow cone vendor was a tall black man in a satin shirt and silver-studded jeans. I wondered how he could stand the noontime heat in that getup. But he looked as cool as the ice he was shaping into cones. When Don asked for 2,
The man took them and deftly began adding syrup from the big plastic dispensers.
"First you put on some blue," he said, in what was probably a standard spiel. "For the sky."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.